What's the best input you can get out of one of these, or even one of these? And this one's got RGB output on it. So as part of the charity auction to sell off these new Spectrums and raise money for the Befriending scheme, I'm wanting to put together really nice packages to raise as much money as possible. The theme of each one is slightly different. For instance, the Metrum is all about, well, it's kind of the everything one, and it's got so many computers covered in it through the different ROMs that it can emulate, or not emulate, that it can actually run. The output on it is already really good because it can do composite and RGB. And alongside that will be this diagnostic cart, and the DivMMC Future will be in the package. And that's going to be like the new modern Spectrum, the modern take on a Spectrum. I'll also be auctioning an original machine, maybe two, in an original box with all original hardware. For instance, the loading mechanism for the original machine will be tape. And this is an amazing tape deck, the Rolls-Royce of tape decks from back in the day, the WH Smith's computer program data recorder, and this one is in lovely condition. This was donated by Repairy McRepair. He refurbished it for me and sent it over to go be included with the auction. So that's the theme of the original machines. And sitting in the middle is this one. This is a new build. You've not seen this one yet, or you might have seen it. I'm not sure which order I'm releasing these videos in. But this one is a completely new, from new components, ZX Spectrum 48K. It's exactly the same as another 48K ZX Spectrum and will behave in exactly the same way, but it's new. So that's the theme of this one. So this one's gonna span the different eras. It comes with a brand new tape deck, a modern brand new tape deck that is going to be used for loading games, but it'll also have a dandinator with it for loading games. So everything's new in this package. But with this one, is composite really enough? Or can we do a little bit better? So here on the desk, I have a package from lovely Ben from Byte Delight. And this is the ZX HD, HDMI interface for the ZX Spectrum. And basically this is a way of adding HDMI to your ZX Spectrum. And this isn't gonna be a long build because there's no soldering involved in this kit. It's just basically put it together, Lego style, and away you go. As usual with Ben, he's provided instructions beyond anybody could reasonably want and expect. And we're going to follow through them now. Assembling your Raspberry Pi Zero. If your Raspberry Pi Zero didn't come with the 40-pin header, mine was provided by me. The first step is to solder the pin header to the block to the Raspberry Pi at the side channel, blah, 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 blah. Carefully check all the soldering contacts before assembling the Raspberry. I did that soldering some time ago, but it looks all right. Right, mounting the top circuit board. This is the top circuit board. The ZX HD consists of two circuit boards. Here is the other one. We have a serial number, 1, 3, 4. I've learned that these are Ben's fours. That's not a 9. 1, 3, 4, 6. Okay, top circuit board, and these are keyed. So look, there's a big hole there. So this obviously goes in that way around. I'm gonna put that flat. There we go. Marvelous. Now we need to mount the Raspberry Pi Zero, which is that way around. Checking my Pi pins are not bent. And insert the circuit board into the case. The case is, it's not a traditional 3D print. It's, I think this is some kind of resin print, and it feels, it feels unusual. It's not smooth and glossy. It's like a matte, but almost a dusty finish. It's really nice. I would not want to stress this too much though. I don't feel like it will be very strong, but it's not going to be bounced around the workshop, so we should be okay. Okay, so that obviously goes in to there like that, button through the front. And the LED is gonna, oh look, it's got an LED insert window. Excellent. What I don't have in here yet is the, oh no, it's got a hole for it. I was gonna say I haven't put the SD card in, but that's quite deep set, that hole, so I'm gonna put it in first. Ben provides in the kit everything you need. Cable as well is here. SD card in an adapter, just in case you haven't got a computer that, or a way of mounting micro SDs. I don't know why that would be a thing though. What size is that? Oh, I'm curious. 32 gigabyte. Slightly overkill, one feels. So we can get rid of that. We've got the screws for the case, and that's the pin header if you didn't have one in your Raspberry Pi. So, okay, that obviously goes back in there. Ah, all right, you've got to be careful because the SD card actually does foul the case. But I kind of bruted it through there. It's fine. It's fine. What does he say next? Oh, that's it. Mount the back plate with the four included screws. So the back plate has got these pins in it to give it some stability, I suppose. I think it just needed to go in the socket a bit more, so let's get these screws in. Looks like we're screwing into 3D printed material, so I'm going to go nice and easy. I've never dealt with resin material before. Yeah, that's a beautiful fit. Okay. Yeah, I wouldn't want to be able to... It's going to be difficult to get that in and out of there. So we've got a HDMI cable, which I'm going to hook up to my capture device. But first of all, I'm going to start the computer up, load a game. I'm going to use my Dandinator for this, because it's just a bit quicker and easier for me to get to the right things to display stuff. But yeah, I'm going to connect it up via composite, capture that way, and then connect it up via the HDMI interface. Right, so I ran into a few problems. The first of which is I can't capture this for some reason. Could be user error. That's not capturing. So the best I can do to show you is actually film the screen. Well, hopefully you can see. Oh, that noise. How amazing that looks. A really nice thing is the aspect ratio is automatically correct. You see why I say that when I switch to composite. Right, so let's take the, this is the chain that I had, Div MMC and the ZX HD. So I'm gonna take the, I'm very scared of breaking that case. Div MMC out and put that in by itself. So we've got the wrong aspect ratio for a start, so I'm just going to quickly go into the settings and see if I can fix that. Right, to the naked eye, I can see there's dot crawl. It's a very good picture for composite because this is a brand new ZX Spectrum and a much simplified composite output compared to the old RF output. The thing that I found with the HDMI version is crisp. Every single pixel is really clearly defined. There is actually quite a lot of dot crawl on this, which is something you just have with the Spectrum and LCD tellies and CRT tellies. Right, so that's built. This is going to be going in the flight case with the new build Spectrum and all its other bits and pieces. If you'd like to have a bid on one of these, they'll be up for auction on the week starting the 9th of September and finishing on the 16th of September, Saturday to Saturday. On the 16th of September, there will be a 12-hour live stream from here, and I've got lots of special guests. Maybe I'll scroll some names up the side, and we'll be having lots of fun on the day, chatting about all sorts of things, retro and who knows what else. The auctions will be finishing at different stages throughout the day, so we can see just what sort of crazy money these things go for. Hopefully lots and lots of money, which we're raising for the Befriending scheme, which is a really great charity that helps young adults, supports them in making friendships and maintaining them, and doing other things like working on a community farm, which is where my son Thomas attends. Farmer Thomas. So yeah, come along for the day and say hello. You don't have to watch the whole 12 hours, but I'll be here the whole time. And maybe if you can't bid on the crazy auctions, then leave us a donation on the Just Giving page, and the link will be in the description. Okay, thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Bye. So glad that the builders have turned up to take down the scaffolding from next door right at this moment. Right, so I ran into a few problems.